Okay, so this is the half leaf experiment. Next, another experiment is, what is the end product of the photosynthesis? Starch. Okay, starch. During the photosynthesis, the starch is produced. How we know? Again, we go for one experiment. That is called the experiment. For this experiment, two leaves are taken. One is normal leaf. Normal leaf. And another one is, that is also healthy and normal leaf, but the leaf is covered with black tape. Black tape. So the black tape covered leaf. So that is called variegated leaf. Variegated leaf. It means, what is the function of this black tape? The black tape stops the sun rays, sun focus, okay? And also it stops the photosynthesis there. So on the variegated leaf, the photosynthesis is stopped. It means the sunlight is obstructed, okay? So you see here, these two leaves are kept in the sunlight, okay? After few minutes of time, and they go for again starch identification. Starch identification. So by using of the test, that is iodine test. So the iodine test clearly gives the result. The normal leaf that clearly turned into the bluish color. Whereas you are seeing here the variegated leaf which is covered or enclosed by tape, that do not turn into the blue color. It become colorless. Why? Because it means the photosynthesis is stopped in this artificial condition. But you are seeing here the photosynthesis is happened. And what is the end product? The product, that is starch, is produced during the photosynthesis. Here, no starch identification, no starch is resulted here. So, according to this experiment, the starch is the end product. The starch is the product formed during the photosynthesis. Okay, this is the one experiment. Another scientist, Joseph Priestley, conducted the series of experiments. So the experiments explains the importance of oxygen. So for his experiments, he take the bell jar. So hence his experiment is called bell jar experiment. Bell jar experiment. So what are the requirements are needed for his experiment means, one is bell jar, and next one rat, and next candle. So these are the material, and another material, that is mint plant. So these material are used for bell jar experiment. Priestley conducted this experiment in serial wise. First, he take the bell jar, clean and bell jar. So the bell jar is like this. So within the bell jar, he lit the light and he kept the rat inside of it. So this is the rat. So you see here, at the first level, the light is lit. Okay. So the rat is live here. But after few minutes, light gone burn off. It means the candle light off. Light off. As well as the rat is died. The rat is died. It means he observed the experiment. During the experiments, when the time is passing, the rat is suffocating for oxygen. It means, you see here, through here, the rat is taking breath as well as light also, it means the fire also need the air. But in this case, after few minutes of the time, the air is contaminated. The air is contaminated and there is a lack of oxygen. Lack of oxygen, the rat is died. And also the light, the candle light also off. Okay, so this is the one experiment conducted. And the experiment followed. Again he take the candle, he light on the candle and he kept the rat inside of it. The rat is live rat, and along with these two he kept the plant. The plant is mint plant. Mint plant. So in this environment, so after few minutes also, the rat do not die. The rat is live. Rat is live in the presence of mint plant. Again, the candle continue to burn on. Okay, it means here in the presence of the plant, there is a release of one breathing agent, and also the contaminated or toxic compounds are absorbed by the green plant, and it is also releases the some oxygen and it purifies the air. So finally he concluded that the carbon dioxide is released from the animals as well as animal breath as well as candle lightning. Next, oxygen also evolved and carbon dioxide is utilized by green plants. Green plants kept under bell jar. Green plants kept under bell jar. So this experiment clearly says that there is a consume of CO2 and also evolve of oxygen during the photosynthesis.